Hello friends, in this video we are talking about types of seasoning. Seasoning of timber is very important before using the timber for any construction work. Types of seasoning. First type is natural seasoning. It may be air seasoning or water seasoning. Air seasoning is carried out in a shed with a platform. On about 300 mm high platform, timber planks are stacked as shown in the figure in next slide, and the care is taken to see that there is proper air circulation around each timber plank. Over a period, in a natural process, moisture content reduces. The well-seasoned timber contains only 15% moisture. This is a slow but good process of seasoning. Water seasoning is carried out on the banks of the river. In air seasoning, as we see, we can get a timber which contains the water only of 15% moisture. In water seasoning, it is done on the banks of the river. The thicker end of the timber is kept pointing upstream so that it will get the current of the river directly on the face. After the period of 2 to 4 weeks, the timber is taken out. During this period, sap content in the timber is washed out to a great extent. The timber is stocked in a shed with free air circulation. Over here, as we can see, this is the typical picture of air seasoning. So you can see we have provided the pillars over which the platform is set, and on the platform the timber members or planks are placed one above other in alternate layers. Generally, the gap of 30 cm is kept between the platform and the ground so that no moisture or the capillary rise take place and will come in contact with timber directly, and free air circulation is provided, and the roof or shading is provided so that to prevent the timber from atmospheric agents. Then come the artificial seasoning. In this method, timber is seasoned in a chamber with regulated heat, controlled humidity and proper air circulation. Seasoning can be completed in 5 to 4 days only. The different methods of seasoning are: in artificial seasoning, first is boiling, then keen seasoning, then comes chemical seasoning and electrical seasoning and other methods. So let's talk about boiling. In this method, timber is immersed in water and then water is boiled for 3 to 4 hours. Then it is dried slowly. Instead of boiling water, hot steam may be circulated on the timber. The process of seasoning is fast but costlier, as this process is fast but it takes more amount of money. Second one, keen seasoning. Keen seasoning is an airtight chamber. Timber to be seasoned is placed inside it, then fully saturated air with a temperature 35 degrees Celsius to 38 degrees Celsius is forced in the kiln. The heat gradually reaches inside the timber. Then relative humidity is gradually reduced and the temperature is increased and maintained till the required time taken place or till the required degree of moisture content is achieved. The kiln use may be stationary or progressive. In progressive kiln, the carriers carrying timber travel from one end of the kiln to the other end gradually, and sometimes they are stationary also, where no movement takes place. The hot air is supplied from the discharging end so that temperature increase is gradual from charging end to discharging end. This method is used for seasoning on a large scale. Third method is chemical season. In this method, the timber is immersed in a solution of suitable salt. Then the timber is dried in a kiln. The preliminary treatment by chemical seasoning ensures uniform seasoning of outer and inner part of timber. Whereas in normal kiln seasoning, what happens? The outer part get more amount of seasoning and proper seasoning, but inner part sometimes get wet. But by adding the chemical seasoning, both the inner as well as the outer parts of the timber get uniform seasoning. Next method was electrical seasoning. In this method, high frequency alternate electric current is passed through the timber. Resistance to electric current is low when moisture content in timber is high. As moisture content reduces, the resistance reduces. Measure of resistance can be used to stop seasoning at appropriate level. However, it is costly process. This technique has been tried in some plywood industry, but not in seasoning of timber on mass scale, as it will require more number of electricity and cost. The next method is air seasoning. The traditional method for drying wood, air seasoning is also the longest, taking 6 to 9 months. To air season wood, stock logs or planks outside or pattern in such a manner that the air can circulate vertically and horizontally through the timber. The raised petals also keep wood away from vegetation and damp ground. As we have seen in the previous figure, we keep the 30 cm distance between the planks or the platform and the ground. Planks and log ends are often wrapped or sealed to prevent excessive moisture loss through these areas. Protect the drying wood from the elements with an overhead canopy. Then comes kiln seasoning. The most common and effective commercial process for drying wood is kiln seasoning, which accelerates the process of removing moisture through the use of external energy. Drying takes 2 days to 1 weekend, depending upon the type of wood. Two methods, progressive and compartmental, are used for kiln seasoning. In a progressive kiln, as we have discussed prior in this video, timber enters at one end and travels on a trolley through chambers with different air conditions to progressively dry the wood. This method produces a constant flow of seasoned timber. Wood seasoned via the compartmental process remains in a single building, where it is subjected to a program of varying conditions until the moisture content is removed. This process is used for hard to dry or expensive woods. Next method is solar kiln. This method combines the speed of kiln seasoning with the low energy of air drying. Solar kiln has single thickness windows on the south side of the structure that works as collectors to trap the sun's energy. Heat collectors made from black metal are attached near the top of the window sheets. Various methods force the heated air to circulate through the kiln to dry the wood. Here we are not using any external energy, we are using the solar energy to heat the wood. Some solar kilns have insulation to retain heat at night, so that at night also the wood will get required heat. This process takes approximately twice as long as traditional kiln seasoning, so the time required is also more as we are using the solar energy. Because of its gentle nature, it is well suited to producing wood for furniture fabrication. Because large amount of wood cannot season, it will take longer time. Then comes the microwave seasoning. Microwave seasoning uses pulse energy directed into timbers to drive out moisture in a manner that will not cause seasoning degrade. This method also provides advantages such as high speed and high quality, and is well suited for seasoning lumber blocks, veneer, chip, paper and wood-based composite materials. Areas in the wood with the most moisture absorb the most energy, resulting in even temperature during the drying process and a uniform moisture content. These factors enhance quality and reduce timber chinking and lapping. But as we are using the microwave, that is the ultrasonic waves or some pulse energy waves, the overall cost of this method is high. So generally we are using this type of seasoning for the material where we required a very high quality wood. In this video, we have discussed about the seasoning of timber, its types and its suitability. Thank you.